Hi there, everyone. This is Pastor Neil Huff from Trinity United Methodist Church in McLean, Virginia. I hope you're having a great week so far. I want to invite you to think with me about a few verses that we find in Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. This summer at Trinity Church, we're reading through the Sermon on the Mount. We're calling it the best sermon ever. You find it in Matthew's chapters 5, 6, and 7. I hope that you'll read along with us as you join us for worship each week. A lot of the verses that we read and the passages that we'll consider are familiar to us. And so we're trying to consider what they mean for our lives. This past Sunday, we kicked off the series of sermons by reading the Beatitudes, those statements of blessing that Jesus begins the sermon with in Matthew 5. And I also read from a few verses just after the Beatitudes. And I want to read them again today and ask you to just think about what they might mean for your life this week. Let's hear these words from Matthew 5. Jesus says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled under people's feet. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven." One of the things that's important for us to pay attention to when we read the Gospels is that Jesus is very often descriptive in what he says, not just prescriptive. In other words, he describes how life is in God's kingdom. He describes what's going to happen to us when we choose to follow him. It's not just him saying, you should do this, or you ought to do this, or this is what God expects you to do, although he does say that too. But when we read these words about being the salt of the earth and the light for the world, Jesus is describing who we are as his followers. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. He doesn't say, well, if you have some extra time, you should think about being salt of the earth, or if it occurs to you, try to be the light of the world this week. He says, that's who you are. That's who we are as his followers. And so instead of encouraging you to do that, to be salt or light this week, I want to ask you how you're doing. And I want to just ask these questions as a way of inviting you to think about your own life. Think about the encounters of your life. Think about the conversations you've had this week, that you're having this week, at home, at work, maybe on Zoom. Whatever you've been doing, how are you salt of the earth for the people that you encounter? How are you light of the world for them? Do they see Christ in you? Are you reflecting the light of Christ in the world around you? I think that when we reflect on questions like those, it calls to our attention the opportunities we have each and every day to share the good news. Don't forget that you are the best Christian someone knows, that people who know that you follow Jesus will look at you and they'll find Jesus in you. And that's why Jesus says, you are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. If you are tempted to forget, like I am sometimes, that people are watching. Our kids are watching. Our friends are watching. Our family is watching. Our coworkers are watching. I encourage you to think about the song that we teach our children. Most of us know it. And I'm not going to try to sing it for you. That would just crash the internet, I'm sure. But I just want to remind you that we hold up our finger and we say, this is a light. We ask the kids to pretend this is a light. And we say, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. And we wave it around and we sing and we laugh and we smile and say, we're going to let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. And then we ask the question, are we going to hide it under a bushel? And we say, no, we're going to let it shine. And then we say, are we going to let anyone it out? No, I'm going to let it shine. So as you let your light shine this week, as you are the salt of the earth and light of the world, don't hide it under a bushel. Don't let anyone it out. You are the salt. You are the light. Let your light shine and let others see God in you. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you that your Son Jesus Christ has come into our hearts and our minds, our lives, our entire being, and that we are salt for the earth and light for the world. And I ask that you grant us the courage we need this day and this week to let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. We pray in the name of the living Christ. Amen. Hope you're having a great week and the rest of the week goes well. Look forward to seeing you on Sunday morning on YouTube and Facebook as we continue to consider the best sermon ever. This week, we're going to continue in Matthew 5. So join us and see what Jesus has to say. Take care now.